What's going on, everyone? So today I'm going to show you how I built my DIY CNC mill. It's been a project I've been working on for the last couple of years now. I enjoy machining and got a manual lathe, but I've always sort of wanted a mill, so thought, why not build my own, because that'll be cheaper. So secondhand machines around where I live, they few and far between, and they're sort of quite pricey for what you get. So this machine, just out of scrap metal, all the steel that you see in this machine is basically scrap that I've either acquired from friends or pulled out of scrap bins. So the machine itself is she's a fairly rigid machine, but there is a lot of work I need to do on it yet. Still want to put some bracing in behind the column to stop a bit of the vibration and things. I need to do some bracing under the actual frame of the machine itself. Being that I'm in a container with a timber floor, it sort of rocks around a bit. So yeah, a bit more bracing on the actual frame, on the legs, and then quite thick steel plate to put underneath the feet to try and spread the load out over the container floor a bit. Pretty much all the hardware, like the linear rails, the ball screws, stepper motors, the servo drive for the spindle, they're all just off of AliExpress. Spindle itself, I've made that all from scratch, just again scrap metal, all turned on my lathe here, old trusty. So the bearings in the bottom here are 40mm bearings, and the ones at the top I think are a 32mm bearing. They're not angular contact bearings or anything like that, like they should be, but just to get the machine up and running, it's good enough. So I've got a carbide end mill that I use. It's got replaceable inserts in it, so that's quite handy. Even the vise, I got that from a friend, just as a, you know, in a deal, so that was quite good. So yeah, show you a little bit more around the machine, some more close-up shots, and then should make the machine do a bit of a dance and cut some steel on it. Bearing in mind, the machine is not finished. It's far from finished. There's a lot to do. I still want to rebuild all this bit that holds the spindle, because at the moment it's just bits of scrap that I've sort of welded all together, and it's a bit janky. not too keen on how it looks, but it does for now. So hopefully I'll be able to use the actual mill itself to machine the parts.
So this is the top plate in the machine. It's a 50mm thick piece of boilerplate that I got off one of my mates. I've cut the sides of it off and they now live down here. So those are now the supports basically for the Z column. The linear rails that I'm running here are 25mm linear rails that I ended up getting from AliExpress, and the ball screws are the 16mm ball screws, which are also on AliExpress. Stepper motors that we're running down here are a 3.6 newton meter NEMA 23 motor, the DM542 driver. They're pretty powerful. I mean, it lifts this head pretty easily and throws that plate around. They've got to have a bit of power to them. The spindle motor up here is a 1 horsepower servo motor. Again, another AliExpress special. Pretty powerful motor. There's a lot of torque in it. You know, when the power really comes on the machine, it'll ramp the power up so it keeps the RPMs consistent. So I guess now you've seen the bit of the machine, then we may as well cut some steel with it.
everyone. That's my DIY CNC mill. If you have any comments on the machine or any ideas or you know, things that you want to know more about, leave a comment down in the description. If you like the video, thumbs up, maybe consider subscribing.